हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू यूट्यूब चैनल क्रैक गेट ऑनलाइन। सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो 1.8 आई डिस्कस्ड यू अबाउट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द डेप्थ ऑफ इम्पाउंडिंग वाटर, मीन्स हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द डेप्थ ऑफ वाटर बिहाइंड द बंड, सो दैट फ्रॉम दिस पैरामीटर वी कैन कैलकुलेट द अदर पैरामीटर्स। सो आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द थ्योरेटिकल मैथड, सो आई डिड नॉट टुक एनी न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई विल टेक वन और टू न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स, so that method will be more clear. So in the last video I told that you have to calculate discharge into equal to area into velocity, and from here you need to calculate the value of h. So I discussed you the entire method. So okay, I discussed in terms of the side slope and the seepage line slope and land slope and the longitudinal slope. So I request you not to remember the equation which I showed you in the last video. Rather, you imagine the picture, you imagine the concept, and based on that you made the calculation. You don't need to remember that formula or the weighted perimeter we calculated in term, that large formula. Rather, you calculate the weighted perimeter itself in the from the given data. That will be more easier. So let's see one numerical problem. So here please read the question. Here it is saying as 350 meter long graded band. Okay, land slope is 3%, so you write land slope as 3%, and the rainfall is 18 centimeter per hour for the time of concentration. If you don't know what is the importance of this time of concentration, I have made one video in the soil and water conservation playlist. You can go and watch there. And the uniform grade of 0.18% along the bund means it is longitudinal slope. Okay, vertical interval is given, land slope is given. So from there you can calculate the horizontal interval. Where this horizontal interval, okay, runoff coefficient is also given. So it is, type of soil is sandy soil. Here type of soil is sandy soil. What will be the use of sandy soil? Here you can know from sandy soils side slope is 2:1, okay, and 5:1 is your seepage line slope. So from seepage line slope and side slope you can calculate the base width, but for this you need to know the height of impounding water. So how you will know the height of impounding water? For graded bund, you know you need to calculate discharge equal to area into velocity. Okay, so how you can calculate the discharge? That is CIA by 36. Okay, and this area here is not same as this area. Okay, suppose this is A dash, because this A dash into 1 by N R, that is A by P, that is A dash by P to the power 2 by 3 into S to the power 1 by 2, that is the longitudinal slope. This is given as 0.18. So this A dash and this A dash is same, but this A dash is not same, because this is the area where you are going to dispose the water. Okay, so this will be equal to 350, that is length into width. What is width? That is distance between two bund, that is horizontal interval. That's why I told you can calculate horizontal interval from using, what is the formula? I told you in earlier video, that is S by 100 equal to VI. VI is given in question as 1.25 divided by HI. And what is the land slope? This S is 3. So you can calculate here HI. HI is given. What is the value of C? C is given 0.35. Rainfall intensity is given as 18. 36 is constant. So you can equate this value from here. Okay, so, or directly you can put the value here. Here all you know, discharge we calculated CIA by 36, N is the Manning roughness equation, S is the longitudinal slope, that is 0.18, okay, and Z is side slope for sandy soil. Z value will be 2. This S is the land slope, that will become 3. Here you know all the parameters, okay. So if you don't want to remember this equation, so you directly remember this figure in your mind. So here it is not 0.3, here it is H, okay. Here it is 100 into H by S, that is 3. Here it is side slope is suppose 2 raised to 1, then here it is 2H, okay. Here it is 5 raised to 1, so you make this like this. So here you make it like this. So again this become 2 times H and this became 5 times H, okay. So all you know now how you will calculate weighted perimeter: this length plus this length. This length will be equal to this square under root plus this square under root, this square plus this square. So you can calculate this all value in terms of H and you can equate it with the value of Q. So from there you can calculate value of H. So you don't need to remember that large formula, rather you can simply calculate it by itself. Once you know the value of H, what the question is asking, it is asking design a dimension of bund. So dimension of bund is nothing but top width, base width and the total height of bund. So it looks very large numerical problem, but once you will solve it is very easy and very easy to understand. So just remember this figure in your mind and you will be able to solve all the question, okay. So here this is the side slope, you have to directly assume as 2 raised to 1, okay, for sandy soil. So here it is one more question, it is related with contour bund. So please do read the question here, and solution is also given here. So for this you don't need to use the value of q equal to a into v, rather it is contour bund, so you have to use the storage area required, that is the maximum runoff to be stored. How you will calculate? Total rainfall minus infiltration, that will be the amount of rainfall which you have to store into horizontal interval. Horizontal interval may be given in the question, or it will be given in terms of land slope and vertical interval. From there you can calculate horizontal interval. So here you need to equate this into the area of storage behind the bund. This is the area of storage behind the bund, that is half base into height, and only the unknown parameter will be height. From there you can calculate the height of impounding water. Solution is also given here, you can follow this solution. If any problem is there, you can comment in the comment box. So these are the two basic type of problems related with contour bund and the graded bund. I have discussed in very much detail. So I hope from this discussion you will be able to solve all type of numerical problems for GATE exam, JRF exam. In JRF they will ask which type of following bund is used for the storage of water. Option A they will give side bund, option B they will give contour bund, option C graded bund, option D lateral bund. So your answer is contour bund. So like this they will give in JRF, and in GATE they will give the numerical problem. So here one more numerical problem is there, okay. So let's quickly discuss here. The flow they have given itself, okay. So value of Q they are giving here. What they are asking, volume of earthwork per hectare. What is earthwork? Earthwork is length of bund per hectare into cross section area. So for cross section area you need total height, you need base height, and you need the top height. So from here first of all you need to calculate the height. From there you add freeboard and you calculate the total height. For base height you need to know the seepage line slope, you need to know the height of impounding water. So I have discussed how to calculate base width and top width, okay. All the relevant information it is given here itself in the question. Seepage line slope is given, side slope is given, land slope is given, okay, runoff coefficient is given, and the bed slope means longitudinal slope. Where it will be used? It will be used in Manning's equation, that 1 by n r to the power 2 by 3 and s. So this s is nothing but the bed slope, that is 0.25. So all parameters is given. So once you will read this numerical, it will feel too long. So here it is free board is also given, 15 centimeter. It has not given in terms of percent. So what your h you will calculate, just add 15%. 15, not 15%, 15 centimeter. So it will become your total height. Okay. So from reading question, it will become too large. But once you will understand, this all large problem will become very easy to you. So I discussed two problems related with graded bond and one problem related with contour bond. So here you will calculate the height and total height, base width, top width, side slope is given, and discharge carrying capacity is also given. So this is your total parameter. So thank you for watching with this video. In the last, I will make the 10th video, that will be the final video of this topics. From there, all your doubts will be more clear. So I hope I have left nothing, but still if you have any doubt, then please do comment. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.